brainwashed him. Because everyone knows that he and I are meant to be together. I would be with him right now if I hadn't done the honorable thing and stayed with Chris. That'll teach me for being so unselfish. God. Me and my damn temper. Okay, it's okay. I just need to get a grip and figure out a way to get my niece's claws out of Luis. Just another chance to show him how wrong she is for him. That she's just a rebound because I rejected him. But now I'm free to be with him. So he can dump her and be with me. But she's the one with him, not me. How can I stop them from being close to each other when I can't even get into the prison? And now I can't even watch them on the nanny cam that Fancy set up to spy on me. I've got to get this thing working again, so I can keep an eye on them. Damn it!
We gotta exercise a little more self-control than this.
Oh, I can't do that. Not when I don't know how much more time we'll have together.
Well, we're not going to have any time together if one of the guards comes in and sees us like this.
Yeah, well, I'm a guard. I was hired fair and square. Okay, so I faked my resume and used a phony name, but everyone thinks I work here.
Yeah, well, even those morons are going to figure it out if they come in and see us together.
Stop worrying so much. There's only one nurse on duty, and she's already made her rounds in this wing, so, we'll be fine for the rest of the night.
You mean?
Mm-hmm. I mean, you've got yourself a sleepover, Prisoner Lopez Fitzgerald.
Sleepover, huh?
Mm-hmm. What's the matter? You never had a sleepover with a prison guard before?
Can't say that I have. No.
Oh my God, Ethan, I just heard about the fire in the mausoleum. Are you all right?
Yes, I've been better, but considering what might have been, I'm great.
Honey, I'm going to call George. I'm going to have him bring the car around. We're going to take you to the hospital and get
you checked out. Stop. Eve already took care of that. Mother, she gave me some oxygen to get the smoke out of my lungs, and I actually got some rest. I feel fine, okay?
Oh, honey, I have never been so scared. You were almost killed.
I wasn't killed, though.
Well, not this time. I hope you've learned the lesson you should have learned a long time ago.
Meaning what?
Meaning that Teresa Lopez Fitzgerald Crane Casey, whatever the hell her name is now, is hazardous to your health. I mean, the girl should come with a warning from the Surgeon General posted across her chest.
Mother.
Don't mother me, Ethan. Not this time. She almost got you killed. You wouldn't have even been in that fire if it hadn't been for Teresa and her never-ending drama queen existence. She almost killed you. Now you have to promise me you are never going to see her again.
Hello, Eve.
Julian, I don't have anything to say to you, and I am very busy right now, so if you could please go.
It's really rather important.
Then I think you should tell it to someone who cares. You know, like Ivy. The ex that you like sleeping with so much.
Well, it doesn't concern her, actually. It's a medical matter.
Well, there's plenty of doctors in the hospital.
I received this very peculiar text message from someone who did not identify themselves.
Julian, I mean it. And if you don't go right now...
And they told me I should check my son's DNA.
Your son? The son that we had together?
Well, they didn't spell it out, but that's how I took it, yes.
Thank you. You know, you've meant so much to me, Chad. You know? I can't hate you because I'm getting attached. I just hate that I have to let you go.
Yeah, well, you need to get used to that.
No, I know, and I will. It's just hard thinking that we're over.
Oh my God. What? Oh no.
Breathe in, breathe out. You keep me alive. You are my passion for life.
Okay, well tell me what the text message said. Okay. Tell me word for word.
But I still have it. Why don't you read it?
See, the sender blocked his phone number and name.
That's what I told you.
You don't have any idea who this is from?
No. I've been racking my brain ever since.
Well, then it must be about our missing son, because Valerie found him.
Well, yes, but she also said that his DNA checked out, that he was a match with us.
Well, that doesn't make any sense, because well, this message is worded as if it's a warning.
Yes, well. That's how I took it as well.
Well, maybe it's not about our son. Maybe it's about Fox.
What do you mean?
Julian, hasn't ever occurred to you that maybe Ivy's lied to you about Fox as well? I mean, the same way she lied to you about Ethan being your son all those years, and you find out that Sam Bennett's really his father.
There's no way I know Fox is my son. I've never been more certain of anything in my life.
I think that's the same thing you would have said about Ethan before the truth came out.
Oh, please, do you really think Ivy would... What am I saying?
Exactly. I mean, come on, this is Ivy we're talking about.
At least I can still make you laugh.
Well, we never had any problems in that area.
What if none of my children are really mine? It was... my jealousy.
Temper. Cheating on me.
Oh, I never thought you'd give me another chance.
You know what? Let's just not even argue about it. Because it's just water under the bridge, so.
Eva. You know, it doesn't have to be. I can change. You've seen me change. I can do it again, only this time. It will last. Oh my God, I love you so very much. Please, just give me one more chance to make it right with us. It's not too late.
It's too late for me, Julian. I'm sorry. You don't know how sorry I am.
All right, I won't press you. Do you think that perhaps you could run a, well, check Fox's DNA? I mean, because if he's not my biological son, I really would like to know before I have to read about it in a tabloid expose.
Yeah, that reminds me. Do you remember that creep J.T. Cornell? The guy who was murdered at Whitney's wedding?
How could I ever get the picture out of my mind of his body inside a wedding cake?
Well, remember there was some computer memory stick.
Yeah, never turned up.
Well, maybe one of the secrets on it has something to do with Fox's DNA.
Well, perhaps. But could you...
Yeah, I'm doing it. I'm going to run Fox's DNA against yours and see if there's a match. It won't take very long. You can wait if you want.
Now, you know what? I'm done with this, Mother.
No, you are not. You are not going to walk away until you can explain to me why you are still panting after her.
Ethan, you are at a crossroads in your life. Gwen is gone.
And Teresa has finally married another man. God help him. You have no legal ties to her. And from what I understand, she wants to have a baby with Jared.
That is never going to happen.
The point is, there is no reason for you to ever have anything else to do with her ever again.
Oh, except that I love her, Mother.
Oh, Ethan! Please explain to me how you can possibly love a lying, conniving, manipulating little bitch! Huh? Well, seems I'm just in time. You must be talking about Teresa.
Oh my God. This doesn't make any sense. This is a gay bar. No kidding. This is Vincent's big surprise. Okay, wait a second. So you think that Vincent's gay, and this is his way of coming out to the world?
Yeah, I mean, maybe.
Yeah, but why would he bother telling me? I don't care. I don't care if he's gay. I don't care if he's green. I don't care what he does with his personal life.
Well, you did hook him up with Valerie. Maybe he feels guilty.
Vincent, I doubt it. Oh my God, I'm sure Valerie didn't know that he was gay. I mean, she thinks that he was having an affair, you know, with another woman. Oh my God, you know what this means?
What?
When I caught Vincent at the motel, there must have been another man in the bathroom.
Could be.
Yeah. But I still don't understand why he would bother telling me. I don't care who Vincent sleeps with. His personal life had absolutely nothing to do with me.
All right, cut it out. I told you I was through with all that.
Yeah, and I'm trying to accept it, man. It's just that whenever I'm close to you, I start thinking about what we have together. You know we're good. You can't deny it either. You and I have something rare. Once in a lifetime.
No, you know, we had something. But that, whatever it was, it's over. I told you, I love my wife.
Man, don't get so hung up on the words. Love, sex, what's the difference? I don't know how you can walk away from this. I'll never meet anyone who makes me feel so good the way you do.
Incredible, deserted tropical island I swept you off to?
What? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's exactly what I mean.
What beautiful palm trees.
Yeah. Like you can see them swaying in the breeze. The shore.
It's perfect. Perfect time. Perfect place.
Perfect woman.
I've got to do is hope that Fancy didn't remember to undo the nanny cam in Luis's cubicle. Come on, come on. No! I can't let this happen! Wait a minute. What am I gonna do? They're not gonna let me in there. I gotta stop them! Speak to the warden. Now!
Passion for life.
Beautiful.
I love you, Louise.
Look what we have here.
More minutes and she would have had him. But I'm too smart for you, Fancy. You lose again. You'll never know what it's really like to be loved by Louise.
Now, let me see, Ivy. You said lying, cheating, manipulate. Oh, you left out two, Tommy.
Rebecca, zip it.
Oh, and cheap. Yeah, now that is our little Teresita. So, what did I miss?
I have just been trying to get through to Ethan about her.
Oh, and he wasn't listening as usual. No, 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 no. You see, she has him wrapped around her little...
Rebecca, enough, okay?
Hey, I was talking to your mother. You know, with all the money that these nations are spending on these weapons of mass destruction, why don't we just farm Teresa out?
Oh, my God.
What? What did she do this time? Oh, I got it. She put more poison in the guacamole.
Guacamole was an accident. It was meant for Alistair, okay?
Come on, Ethan, please. Her resume reads like a bad novel. Oh, poor, poor, pitiful Teresa.
He almost died tonight because of her.
Well, Frida can't say he doesn't deserve it after what he did to my Gwenny.
Excuse me. Your daughter left me.
Because of Teresa. Always because of Teresa. And, you know, quite frankly, I think you deserve whatever you get. If you do not take this opportunity to get that little tramp out of your life.
That's what I've been trying to tell him. She is married to Jared. They want to have a baby.
Mm. As if a simple wedding band is going to keep her from chasing Ethan. Please, don't you remember how she got herself impregnated by Julian when he was engaged to me? And I'm sorry, Ivy, but I have very little sympathy for your son when he defends her over everybody, including his wonderful, loyal wife.
How is Gwen? Have you heard from her?
Yeah, I spoke to her. And she says she's okay, but I just don't believe it. Ethan spoke to her, too.
You did? You didn't tell me that.
There was nothing to say. She didn't even want to hear my voice, and there was someone else with her.
Yeah, well, the worst thing is that we have absolutely no idea where she is.
Well, I'm sure she'll tell us in her own good time. But it's obvious that she's moved on.
I would not be so sure about that, all right? I mean, something is not right. I can feel it. You know, you need to call her again.
Call? No, not after the way she talked to me last time. No way.
Oh, that's right. You're far too busy chasing after that little tart who keeps marrying other men and having their babies. Ethan, look at it. I mean, she is married to Jared. She's going to have his baby the same way she had Julian's the minute my back was turned.
I must say, I love Fox so much, there's nothing I wouldn't do for him if it turns out he's not my real son.
Ivy will have hoodwinked you again.
How much longer is this going to take?
Almost there. Come around and look at this.
What am I looking at?
Okay, since Fox was in the hospital recently, we have his DNA on file. So I ran his DNA against yours. There's a few indicators we look for, so look at the numbers in column B.
Yes, yes, they're the same.
Yes, they are. You and Fox have nearly identical DNA. He's your son, Julian.
Thank God. What the hell did that text message mean if it wasn't about our son, or what about Fox? Must be about little Ethan. What if that message about checking out my son's DNA was about the child I had with Teresa?
Do you see him anywhere?
Vincent?
No. It's pretty crowded in here. Didn't know that Harmony had such a big gay population.
Me either.
Isn't that guy that runs the dry cleaners?
Yeah.
Don't point, he'll be embarrassed. You think? Nobody around here looks very shy, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
He's not here anywhere. And you know what? It's just as well.
Why do you say that?
Well, because Chad doesn't like Vincent. He probably wouldn't like me meeting him here. But you know what? It is starting to make sense.
What?
Well, remember I was telling you that Chad was acting awfully homophobic?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it seemed really out of character for him.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I think that Chad maybe sensed or knew that Vincent was gay. You know, and just got kind of weirded out about it and started, you know, how he was behaving towards my sister and Ray.
Yeah, and those two guys with the little boy that plays with Miles.
Yeah, it just completely came out of nowhere. And this whole anti-gay thing is just really throwing me for a loop. Yeah, he wouldn't like it at all if he caught me in a place like this.
Okay. Well, he's not going to hear about it from me.
Okay.
Tenders, the way you look in those black jeans.
Yeah, you can stop anytime now.
I'm just getting warmed up, baby. I've got a long list of reasons why I don't want to leave you.
I'm not interested.
Liar.
Look, it doesn't matter what we had. I want to be with my wife, and only my wife. Okay, man, I want to be a good husband and a good father, and it doesn't include hooking up with you ever again. I gotta go.
If you must.
Oh, my God.
What's the matter?
It's Whitney. She can't see us here together. Whitney can't find me here with you, man. I gotta get out of here.
Oh, I feel for you, man. But if you try to get past her and her friend, she's definitely gonna see you.
Oh, man, I am done. I can't explain my way out of this one.
Cool your jets, yeah. Follow me.
Yeah, where are you going?
To save your cute butt, if that's what you want.
You know that's what I want. Wait. Why are you trying to help me? Now, you've been trying to blow my cover to Whitney for weeks now.
I was upset. All right, but I don't want to see you get busted. So you coming or not?
Vincent's not here anymore. No. Besides, you know what? If all he wanted to do was come out of the closet, I don't care. Why would he want to make the big announcement to me?
I don't know, Whitney. You know, maybe this has been weighing on him and he just felt this need to tell someone. I know what that feels like.
And you know what? You could get over that feeling if you went ahead and told Ethan the truth about his son.
I want to. I want to tell him so bad, but I can't. You know, I mean, too many lives are at stake. And even if I could tell him, Whitney, he would just hate me forever.
Look, if you two want to bash Teresa, fine, but you'll do it without me, okay?
No, Ethan, please, don't go. I'm sorry. You know, we just want to spare you any more agony at the hands of that woman.
Well, Mother, I happen to love that woman, okay? So if you want to maintain any kind of relationship with me whatsoever, I suggest you stop bad-mouthing her. It's not going to change how I feel, all right? That's the end of the story. Have a good night.
Can you believe him? After everything that tramp has done, what am I going to do?
You're looking at the wrong person here. I mean, I have done everything I could think of, and she still keeps coming at us like a little Terminator. Oh, that poor Jared Casey has no idea what he has married.
That's just what I'm talking about. She's married to another man, and Ethan still won't let her go.
Why? Maybe there is something we can use to wake up Ethan. Look, we all know that Teresa has this deep, dark secret, the one the blackmailer is using against her. Well, it must be pretty bad. I mean, she's probably afraid she'd lose Ethan over it.
What good is it if we don't know what it is?
We find out. We sniff it out till we get to the bottom of it. And then we see how long Ethan still loves Teresa.
What if this text message isn't a prank? What if the son I'm supposed to compare my DNA with is little Ethan?
Well, we'll know in a minute because I'm cross-checking it right now. All right, I have the results. Now, we're looking for the same indicators that I just showed you, and you can see little Ethan's DNA matches up there with Teresa's. But not with yours, Julian.
What do you mean?
I mean, you are not little Ethan's biological father.
I always knew you didn't fit in around here, Chicky. You ain't no guard.
I am too. I'm sorry. I just got carried away with the prisoner.
Yeah, right. Just like last time. You're the girl the warden's been turning this place upside down looking for all week. You're a fancy crane.
No.
You're in trouble, Blondie. Big trouble.
Okay, you don't have to tell the warden about this. We can work something out.
Oh, as much as I might like that, I ain't making no deals. Besides, it's too late. What do you think I'm doing here anyway? The warden got a phone call from outside tipping him off that you were in here.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. The warden's on to you. Told me to tell you you were relieved of your duties ASAP. And don't come back unless you want him to press charges.
Okay, you've got it all wrong.
You just tell the warden this is my fault, okay?
I'll save it, Buster. You're both in hot water. Party's over. Get your clothes on. My orders are to escort you out of the prison.
Well, I can't very well get dressed with you standing there.
I'll be right here.
I'm so sorry.
Don't blame yourself. You should have never let things get so out of control.
Yeah, I wanted them to. So if you don't blame yourself, Louise.
Well, who else am I supposed to blame?
That wasn't too difficult. You see, Fancy, I can have anything I want. And what I want is Louise.
Any luck? I did see the guy that works at the laundromat, the other guy that mows my mother's lawn, and that nice clerk at the bank.
But no Vincent.
No Vincent. I don't know why he would go through so much trouble to get me here, but one thing's for sure, it wasn't to see him.
Maybe.
You know, whatever game he's playing, I'm done. Let's just go.
Okay.
Well, you set this up, didn't you? He set it up so we would come here and catch us together.
You don't know that.
You set this up so my wife would come here and you'd scare me into staying with you, didn't you? Now just admit it, Vincent. You got my wife to come here, didn't you?
Damn it. What the hell are you doing to me? Huh? You can't tell Whitney anything. Okay, not one word.
What? Hmm? You gonna take a shot at me again? Hmm? Are you packing tonight or what?
I don't need the gun for what I should have done months ago. Ouch.
Oh, I'm not done yet. I'm sick of you, man. I'm sick of your threats. I'm not gonna let you destroy everything that I hold near and dear.
Don't stop now. You remember how turned on our boys got in our favorite movie when they started cowboy tussling?
Shut up.
All right. I didn't hear you.
Oh, what, you want me to hit you again? It'd be my pleasure.
Get off! You know you want me.
Hey there, ladies. Is one of you named Whitney?
Yeah, that's me.
I didn't mean to scare you. We just don't get too many women in here, you know, so I figured.
Oh. How did you know her name was Whitney?
I'm supposed to give this to you. Right now, in fact.
Who told you to give this to me?
I don't know. Maybe it says in there.
It's got to be from Vincent. Open it up. And what's it say?
It says come to the storage room. Well, do you have a storage room?
Yeah, in the back.
Okay, so why would Vincent tell you to go there? Only one way to find out.
I did it. I kept them from making love, and I didn't even need Spike's help to get me in the prison this time.
Oh, I knew I would find you in my room. I knew you were the one who must have called the prison warden about me and Louise. How dare you spy on us?
You were the one that set up the nanny cam and were stupid enough to leave it hooked up next to Louise's bed. Did you forget to disconnect it? Or were you so hell-bent on stealing Louise away from me that you forgot you were taping yourself?
Oh, damn you, Sheridan. I am not stealing Louise from you or anyone. He has told you it was over between you two. I've heard him tell you myself. What more do you need to hear?
That he finally realizes that he's with the wrong woman. You know what? You deserve to be busted because you were dressed up as a prison guard. I was only doing my civic duty by reporting you.
Oh, this coming from someone who posed as a nun to sneak into the prison.
You know what? I liked my costume better. Besides, I will do whatever it takes to be with a man I love.
Even if he doesn't love you.
Luis has been through so much, he doesn't know what he's feeling right now.
God, you say you love Luis, but you couldn't possibly. He is alone, with no one to help him now. Are you proud of yourself?
Proud? No. But if I can't be in there, then you can't either. So now we're even.
Oh my God, that's all you care about? Some competition with me. Luis is sentenced to die.
That's not my fault.
God, I don't know how you look in the mirror, Sheridan. Now Luis is in more danger than ever, and if anything happens to him in there, it's going to be on your head.
I got good news and bad news.
Something tells me you're going to tell me what it is, whether I want to hear it or not.
You're going back to your old cell soon. Back in general population.
What are you talking about? I thought death row inmates spend time in solitary.
Ah, warden's making a special exception in your case. That's the good news.
Okay. So what's the bad news?
Well, you know how your fellow inmates feel about ex-cops.
Well, I can handle that.
Maybe you could have. But there's something else. The warden's taking away privileges from everyone on your cell block. Telling him it's on account of you breaking the rules.
Well, that doesn't seem fair.
They're not gonna like that at all. I'm already taking bets on how long it'll take you to end up back here in the prison infirmary. That is, if you're still alive when they're through with you.
Little Ethan has to be my son because Teresa got pregnant the night that we were supposedly married in Bermuda.
The night that both of you were so drunk, you don't even remember whether anything happened. And Julian, can you be 1,000% sure that you were even able to consummate the relationship with her?
Eve, that's only happened to me that one time.
Julian, I'm just asking because according to this, little Ethan can't be your biological son.
Teresa is going to be as shocked as... Wait a minute. I bet that little bitch has known all along.
Julian, you don't know that.
She's had to have known. She just didn't tell anyone because she likes the fact that her little boy's last name is Crane. It has entitled her to manage the estate since he is the heir to the estate, but he is not. Oh, my God.
Oh, God. What are you thinking?
What a jerk I have been. It all makes sense. I know who little Ethan's real father is.
Hey, Teresa, it's me. I was hoping to get you in person, but I guess this message will have to do. Look, I just wanted to say that I love you. And I don't care about this blackmailer. I don't care about anybody else. Nothing's going to keep us from being together, okay? Through my life, nothing's gonna change that.
If only my sweet JT were still alive.
I know I could coax a secret out of him.
Well, be that as it may, it's gone now.
Yeah, and that cute little USB stick thingy. I mean, the one that had all the secrets on it. I mean, all we have to do is find it.
Apparently, it didn't just contain Teresa's secrets. It had things that could damage a lot of people.
What difference does that make as long as it has Teresa's?
So JT didn't give you any hint at all? I mean, you have no idea where it could be?
Ivy, please. If I did, do you really think I'd be standing here drinking with you?
There it is. You sure you want to do this? Because we can just go.
No, let's just do it. We've already come this far, you know? Let's see what Vincent's big surprise is.
You, Tabitha, to see if you're a good witch or a bad witch.
Teresa, she has been lying all along.
Do not get near me, Chad!